So first of all, I'll give you access to this video. We usually shoot everything we do. We have a new membership site. I'm sorry, I keep thinking I have my glasses on because I'm looking at someone here and I'm like, it feels like they're still there because they were there all day long, I guess. We'll give you access to this on our new membership site. It's at possibilitiesinmind.com. So if you look on your sheets, there's another sheet. Should I tell them now? Or I'm supposed to tell them later, right? Okay, sorry. I like giving stuff up. Okay. So like I said, this will be on the new membership site. You just have to register. It's free. I tried to program everything before I left, and Steph, which works with us in Chicago, she didn't have the time to complete it. So well, when we see your emails, like you, I think you had four people at the same time. So if they can give the email and register, we'll know from there. From that point on, we'll give you access to a video called How to Communicate with Your Guides. So if you forget what I did, what I did today, you'll be able to have access online at any time. This footage will be there probably by next week. It takes a little bit of time to edit and probably cut the bloopers if I make any and stuff like that. Should do a special section for that. And so I've been doing this for about 2 decades. I'm not that old, so don't worry about it. I started when I was 23. I started developing my own psychic abilities. For those of you that don't know, I started helping people with, you know, some of the worst cases like incest, rape, trauma, all that type of bad stuff. And at one point, I started being able to know what people would tell me before they would tell me. And so I developed, or I began to learn that I had intuitive abilities. So one day, I was talking to this woman, and after 40 minutes, I started seeing on top of her head the operation room in which she was in while she was giving birth. And her problem was that she didn't love her husband anymore, and she had not loved him for about 8 or 9 years, if I remember correctly. And she came to see me to find out, well, how come? So at one point, I start seeing this movie of the operating room, and I see her, I see the doctors. I said, did you give birth in the hospital? She said, yes. I said, were there, you know, how many doctors and nurses? She said, yes. I said, well, I see you, I see your husband, and then it turns really dark. And she remembered that when her baby was born, they gave the baby to the husband, and the husband said, you know, that's the ugliest thing I've ever seen. And so the relationship from that point on was dead in the water. So when she remembered that, I was able to help her give forgiveness, and then she healed. And she's the one that asked me if I was a medium or psychic. At the time, I knew a little bit about it, and I said, well, I don't know. And so later on, what I did is I started studying by going to see other psychics and mediums and finding out how do they do it. And then I created my own process, which you'll see in How to Communicate with Your Guides, and which we're all gonna do later on. So later on, I had more clients in that sensing. I started doing more things with corporate and then medicine. And at one point, one day I had a dream. A spirit guide came to talk to me and asked me if I would help somebody with AIDS, which I said, sure, why not? I thought they were gonna give me the cure for AIDS. I'm like, okay, let's go. Okay, that turned out actually pretty well. Anyway, so I helped this woman that had AIDS. First of all, I called a student of mine that I just trained to develop intuitive abilities. And she said, well, you're gonna meet somebody in 2 weeks that has AIDS and she's looking for help. So I'm like, okay, cool. So I wait. And 2 weeks later, she calls me and she says, there's somebody in the newspaper, a woman asking for help, she has AIDS. And I thought, that's her. So I went to see, I explained to the doctor, you know, I can help. I use these different abilities. I can help her boost her immune system. And he said, sure, as long as the patient is okay with it. She said, yes. So I helped her for a while, I think 1 or 2, 3 months. And unfortunately, she passed away. But near the end, when we started doing the test, we could see that she was getting better. She was sleeping all the time. She wasn't doing any activities. And about 3 months later, she started moving again, eating, talking to other people, socializing. And at one point, the doctor said, well, what are you doing? I said, well, I'm doing this. If you want, if you help me, I'll help you. So I'll help you see what I'm doing. So I helped him communicate with his guide, like I'm going to do with you. And he was able to see around her bed that people are there. funny thing is I couldn't see nothing. So I'm like, oh yeah, no, that's cool. Really cool. What else you see? I'm like, I don't see nothing. I didn't tell him that though. that would have been really big. And he's like, well, I see these people and totally change them. I met him 6 months later and he said it totally changed my life because at the time in 95, I believe, AIDS just, you know, was, it still is, but it was a very, very, how do you call it, disastrous disease in which, you know, people just died. You knew that if you had that 6 months later, it's over. So now, you know, there's medication, stuff like that, that helps. But at the time, he was able to see that there's spirit guides that are there to help me make that transition. And I thought, wow, that's cool. I wish I could see that. Anyways, so over time, I started teaching more doctors, more people, patients, clients in business, stuff like that. I mostly went towards the business side because medicine takes too long. So they said, yeah, well, we're ready to help you and, you know, fund something, but you'll have to do it and do trials and testing and stuff like that. And I'm thinking, I almost died the first time around. I'm going to do this again just for free like that. So I started doing more business stuff. And at one point I started, I was at my office in Gatineau. And this woman came to see me, and she was so sad, and she said, you know what, this friend of mine passed away, and I'm really sorry that he passed, and I think it's my fault, and I'm about to kill myself. And when she said that, the alarm bells went in my head. I'm thinking, oh my God, do I call the police, or what do I do now? So I talked her down for about an hour and a half, and I said, listen, I'll make a deal with you. If I can communicate with that person, and he tells you that he's okay or that it's not your fault, promise you won't do it. That's about how far away. And she said, okay. So I'm thinking, okay, well, how am I going to do this? So I figured a way to contact that person by a process I'll explain in a couple of minutes. And the person did validate that it wasn't her fault. And from that point, she started creating more success in her life. And I thought, wow, that's a good way to help people that are about, you know, to commit suicide. So I've done a couple of like that over the years. And at one point I went to see John Edwards. Does anybody know John Edwards here? He's in the US. John Edwards is famous from his, I forget the show. What was the show called for John Edwards? Anybody know? I forget. I'm sorry?
Crossing Over,
that's correct. He had a series for about 5 seasons or so. Anyways, so I went to the US to see him because I went to understand a little bit more. There was about 6,000 people there. And when it was over, there was this woman, you know, crying profusely. And I went to see her and I said, what's wrong, you know? And she said, well, I really wanted to talk with them and now I didn't have the chance. So, you know, and her daughter said she didn't have the chance. So she's really, really sad. And I thought, well, you know, there's 6,000 people. What are the chances? I said, listen, I'm here to understand what he's doing. And I do similar. If you want, we'll go to the restaurant. I'll talk to the people on the other side for you. And then you probably can get the message that you want. So my friend and my, Ron, go to a restaurant. She's with her daughter. And I start talking to her, and she's crying all along. And at one point, I asked a question to the person on the other side, and he says, tell her, don't do what she's about to go do. And I look at her, and I said, well, do you understand what he said? So she starts crying even more. And then I look again on the other side, and I ask him, you know, what does it mean? In my mind, of course. And he says, just tell her, don't do what you're about to go do. And I look at her, and I look at him, and I figure out, I say, were you about to commit suicide? And she says, yes, I was going home, and I was going to kill myself. You should have seen her daughter's face. And so I'm thinking, wow, I'm from Ottawa, Canada. I'm going to Indianapolis for one day, the week before the Formula One, and I'm here, and this woman just saved her life. She went through 3 states to drive there, and she was going to go back and do it. And I thought, wow, this is beyond what I can imagine. And so I decided to do this a little bit more, and that's what I'm going to do with you tonight in terms of helping you communicate with somebody on your side. We're a small group, so hopefully I can help as many people as I want. We'll go, I said around to 8:30 or 9. I'll try to go as much as I can. I have a doctor here with me to make sure if I pass out. She knows CPR too, is that cool? And there's a nurse here too, so I'm in good hands. All right, so the process I take is very simple. We'll start in a couple of minutes, okay? What I ask you to do is your participation, because if you don't have me talk to somebody at her side. There's no use for me to be here tonight, okay? Or you, for that matter. If you're too shy or scared, don't, you know, we're, the only thing I ask for people is to respect that, you know, we have our own beliefs on this side, and they have their own beliefs on the other side. So first of all, if they don't want to talk to you, I can, you know, tell them and ask them again, but if they don't, they don't. There's nothing I can do. If I can't communicate with them, I'll tell you, because I'll show you the process that I use in a minute. And I only ask that everybody respects the other person on the other side and the person on this side asking questions. Even though sometimes it'll appear that, you know, the person is asking a question and nobody knows what that means or what it's for, it doesn't make any sense. For that person, that message might mean something, all right? So if you look at me and I look like I'm not, I don't know what's going on, or that's perfectly normal, don't be afraid. Okay. I'm like that most of the time, so anyway, so. Another thing I wanted to do, so the process I use is very simple. I'm going to do it with you, and then afterwards, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna explain how you can communicate with your guides, and I'm also gonna look at, you know, what happened and what that meant, or some messages, what they meant, and how I work, my brain works, so that I can explain to you how I do it visually, okay? And how my world is, and probably you can see the world the same way. All right, so the first thing I need is, when you ask me a question, is the name of the person and the age. I'll write it down, because if you notice that I ask your question 50 times, that's because my brain is going back and forth. So I might look at you and I don't know who you are, don't remember your name or something like that. It's part of the, it's not a glitch, okay? It's not a pinball, but it goes like that, okay? So I'll ask and then I'll go, okay, what's your name again? What's the name again? So just be patient with me, please. Okay, remember, this is the other side. So I'm gonna do like Bell and reach out and touch someone. Here we go. So I'll just write it here. First of all, welcome. Okay. Okay, so the age, the name, okay? When I wanna know the age is, at what age did the person pass away? Okay, that's the most important part. So what I'll do is, once I have that, what I'll do is I'll locate the person on the other side. And then from there, I'll validate with you, okay? Maybe I'll tell you this person looks this way, or is that size, or, you know, usually wears this, or has certain mannerisms, or, you know, talks a certain way. And then when you say yes, I believe that's the right person, because there's a lot of people on the other side. There's a lot on this side, but there's also a lot on the other side. So once I locate and validate them, then I'll give you some information that probably you know and can validate, and then I'll start from there, okay? So usually we'll try to run about 10 minutes each or something like that, or as long as they're there, okay? And then I'll take somebody else, all right? Is there somebody that would like to start?
Mitch is
going
to go first.
That's good. We got good volunteers. Okay.
I have a question.
Yes?
If I don't have anybody specifically, yep, that I want to reach out to, mm-hmm, is that okay? Can you just be randomly, hey, is there anybody there that wants to?
I can try.
Does that ever happen, or would that be like, hey, nobody's waiting for you, Audrey?
Let's just remember one thing. You're not alone. I'm going to write it down. You're not alone. Yeah, I can look around you. Right now I see a woman. Oh, no, that's you, Christy. No, I'm just kidding. Okay. So what I'll probably do is ask you to come up front, or a chair that's closer, so I don't mix things up. Because I do sense a woman this on that side for you. It's not Christy this time, so that's okay. So yeah, we can probably do that. It's very different with everybody. I find that protocol faster for me and to help people at the same time. But I've, you know, been places and I can see people around that person, and I just go from there. Okay, spooks them out, spooks me out. Okay, your name again, please?
Mitch,
sorry, there we go, started already. Okay, so Mitch, what's your age, Mitch?
Sorry. I'm gonna be 53.
53? Okay. Are you sure? You hesitated there.
Yeah, you're good? Myself,
okay.
53 in September.
Okay. And the person you want to communicate with? Your father? Okay. Is everybody in terms of temperature okay? Yes? Okay. What's your father's name?
Ben.
Ben?
Benoit.
Benoit, oui.
Richer.
And what age did he pass?
63.
I hear cardiovascular. Does that make sense?
Close.
Okay, just a second. Thoracics. Cardiovascular. Thorax. Yes? Just a moment. I see him. Was he a bit little bigger than you?
He was a stocky.
Stocky? Okay, yeah. I got him. Just give him a moment. Mm-hmm. Okay, just stay there for a moment. Okay, that's good. he has an impressive presence.
Yeah.
Okay, got it. Just a second. Yes. Okay. Does he move slow also when he moves?
He did.
Okay, I got him. He scared me, that's why. Just like this. And I'm like, oh, okay. All right, just give me a second here. If you see me moving or going backwards, for me, this is all like, it's like if Mitch was in front of me. So, okay, so I'll just write, I'm gonna write big. It's just easier. Okay, and slow movement. I'm sensing he's also calm, and his voice might be a bit more deeper.
Yes.
That's correct, yes?
Yeah.
Okay, okay, I got him. Just a moment. Oh, we got more than enough for this. Okay, just a moment here. Okay, so I don't need that anymore. Just a second here. I'm sorry, what's his name again, your father? Ben, Benoit, yes. Okay, perfect. All right, so he's right here in my mind. All right. He left your mom, is that correct?
It's almost like that.
Okay, that's what he says. I asked him, you know, can you tell me something that Mitch would be able to recognize? He says, left your mom or something in that sensing.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yes, okay, so that's him. All right, so now that I've validated that's with him, I'll just close my eyes for a while because it's easier. I'm not sure why in terms of communicating with him. So is there something in particular you wanted to say? He says he loves you, first of all, and he seems to be, somebody close that door. Thank you. Okay, where is he? This. He seems to be going towards you and touching your, I'm not sure if it's your right or left, like this here. Does that make sense to you? Did he do that before?
I would think so, yes.
Okay, this is what he's doing now to acknowledge your presence and also saying he's loved you. I speak slowly and deeply, so is there anything you would like to ask him since he's there?
God, there is so much.
You don't have to worry.
Why did he give us the life we...
I'm sorry, say again?
He didn't give us the life we deserved.
Why? Okay. He said he didn't have it for himself. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, and he said don't worry about something or don't... I'm trying to listen here. You don't have to worry about something. I'm not sure, it's not coming through clearly. Does that tell you anything so far? I know it's pretty vague, but.
No.
It's a movement like that he's making all the time. This is like charades. Sorry. I'm sorry, go ahead, ask questions. He's still doing the same movement and same thing. I think he's trying to tell me something, but I'm not understanding what it is. Go ahead. It has to do with regrets. Or something?
Yeah.
Were you two? He says two. Were you two children or two, you and your mom or something? Or
my family's two boys, two girls.
Okay, so two.
Never married my mother.
Okay.
She gave me a married second. Her sister.
Okay, so you're mentioning something about regret and the loss of something. one, two, three, four, five. He's showing me the number 16, so it could be 16 years ago or something related to the word 16. Does that tell you anything?
I was 16 when he died.
Okay, I'm sorry. So my sympathies again. Yes. He wants you to know he's really there. And he said he's really trying to own up to something. Own up to, I think it's own up to the fact that he wasn't there.
Yeah.
It's very hard for him. He looks, my head says like a German military.
Exactly, he was German.
Oh, okay, there you go. he's crying now. He says he misses you, and it's something about his culture. It's like he was solid and he was like structured. And there's a lot of things he didn't understand that now he's beginning to understand by seeing you. And you have children?
No.
Are you taking care of somebody?
No.
Just a second. He's showing me like you're taking care of somebody, or the way you're running your life, you're doing something better than him.
I'm helping someone who's like a son to me.
I'm sorry, say again?
I'm helping someone who's like a son.
Okay, so that's it. So that he's observing you doing that because he's there. Yes. Like I said, you know, we're not alone. And so that for him, when he watches that, it makes him cry. It's as if it's something about his culture or his structure or, do you understand what I'm talking?
Yes.
Okay, perfect, thank you. Yes, thank you, just a second. You stay there, yes, thank you. Is there something you want from him, he said, or you would like from him? He's ready to do something, or I'm not sure.
Well, I'm learning to forgive.
Okay.
Accept the way it was.
Okay.
It's going to take time.
Is there something you need from him, he says? You.
Keep in touch.
He does. He's showing me, I think it's your house. Do you have a house or a cottage in the woods or something? Okay, so there's trees there. Do you have sap trees or there's a specific type of tree that's related to snow or something? Does that tell you anything?
I'm sorry.
I see trees and I see snow, so I'm wondering if there's like sap trees or something.
Yeah.
Okay, so he's there. Do you collect stuff? He's showing me you're doing this. I hope that doesn't mean you're pouring drinks. What is that? Don't worry, you're on camera, so watch your language.
My joy of watering my plants.
Okay, so he's there when you're doing, yes, thank you very much. Okay, so yes. So, yes, thank you. So when you're doing that, this, yes, just talk. I don't speak German, right? Just a second. Just give me, I need a translator here. Yes, thank you.
He did speak into Deutsch, yeah.
Yes. So the gardening for him is what he would have liked to be with you, he said. Do you understand? It's
yes.
The gardener. This is him. He watches you when you do that. That's, yes, thank you. That's the moment he's most proud of you, in that moment of love. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, thank you. Does that help you?
Yeah.
Yes, thank you. Does that help you forgive him, he says? He asks, sorry.
It will happen when I can learn to communicate now that I know he's around.
Okay. So let's pray we can do that in about an hour or so from now when I teach you and stuff like that. Yes. Das. Isn't das Russian? Is das German or Russian?
German.
Oh, okay. He says das. Okay. That means yes, I think. Is that? Anyways. The only das I know is Volkswagen. So.
Exactly.
What does das mean?
Da.
Da? Okay. Yes. 39. He says he's proud of you. You've evolved enough. You've evolved a lot, and he's showing me the number 39. So maybe since you're 39 or something happened when you were 39, does that make sense?
I think it's when
yes,
probably turned my life around.
Just give me a second, will you? Thanks. I'm sorry if I'm It's like a kid keeps talking. You tell him, wait a minute, just keep talking. Yes. This, yes. Yes, yes. So this is the moment he shows me in which your anger started to be alleviated, as if, yes, thank you. Not a cure, but a healing of some type for you that that enabled you to set a different course. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, thank you.
It's around 39, you're right.
Okay. He says, I can't hear you. I think he says sorry to say sorry to your mother or something. Does that make sense to you?
Yep.
Okay. Sorry, I have this, he's saying this and I have the Justin Bieber song that I've heard with Christy during the car this afternoon all day long. Why am I still hearing the song? Yes. Okay, it's a song, but it actually means something. I think it's not too late for her also if she wants to forgive. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Where are they? Okay, thank you. Do you have any other questions? Because they're coming to get them. Well, not get them, I mean. Because it's just the way I'm seeing it. That's my language. They're coming to, he's going to leave so far, in a couple of seconds. You, yes, no, Mitch? Sorry.
I'm good.
You're good? Okay.
Yeah.
He's doing this with his hand and another movement. Does that tell you anything?
We used to spar.
Okay. Well, I hope he doesn't do that with me. Okay. All right. So this.
There's a fighter.
There's a more deep message for you with that one. Just a second. So this, yes. Did he move your hands and show you how to spar, or did you just spar?
We just sparred.
He's showing me as if he's showing you how to make your hands like this right now. Does that mean anything to you?
Yep.
Okay, all right. So yes, thank you. So he leaves you that message. Keep on going, he's saying. Okay, thank you. Just give me a second here. Where are my guides? Oh, there they are, okay. Okay, good. All right, oh, geez. Okay, I forget you're here, sorry. Okay, perfect. All right, so did that answer, it was you asking the questions, right? Okay, thank you. All right, I'm still good. All right, okay. All right, so part of this process is when I'm done, I open my eyes, so thank you for not moving everywhere. That would sort of make me disoriented. Another thing is, in a couple of seconds, I'll totally forget, if not already, what Mitch, right? What Mitch talked about. Okay. So what happens is that I'll explain after. I'll take another person. Just give me one moment so I can center myself here. Was that helpful? Did you enjoy? Yes.
Absolutely.
Okay. So, yes. Thank you. One of the process that I want to go through with you also while I do this is the learning and the educational part of it. Just to, you know, show you as probably Mitch here, I don't remember, sorry Mitch, but probably some of you have learned either about you're not alone or forgiveness or the connection. But the most importantly is that there's something more than who we are. There's, how do you call it? There's a whole dimension. And so death is just, you know, another stage of life, if you want to call it in that sensing, another, I'll explain a bit later. Yes, thank you. We're ready? Okay, good. Okay, so if we can have somebody else who wants to volunteer? Yes? Earl, how are you? Okay.
My grandmother.
Your grandmother, okay. Agnes, yes, okay. Have I communicated with her before?
No.
No, okay. Earl is the, interestingly enough, Earl, I've coached for quite some time and I never met him. This is the first time I meet him in person. Okay, so, perfect. And he's actually the first person that registered, I think. Okay, so, thank you again, Earl. Agnes, right, Earl? Agnes. What's her last name?
Commander.
I'm sorry. 94? Wow.
Yeah. And I'm 64.
Hmm. Was she short?
Shorter.
A big. I'm sorry, say again?
Big.
I didn't hear you?
No.
Okay. And was she short? You said no?
Yes?
Is that Aboriginal?
Yes.
Okay. There's a name they have for her. I can't hear it. Was she a wise woman or?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. I got her. Very easy. Maybe she did stuff like I did before. She did?
She was a seer.
A what? A seer? Oh, that's why it's so easy. I'm like, who's looking at who? Okay, perfect. All right, I got her. Okay. Which language did she speak?
Which language?
Yes.
Ojibwe.
How do you spell that one, please?
O-J-I-B. W-A-Y.
Okay, I think this is, does it sound like little consonants?
Yeah.
Okay, that's what she's speaking. Okay, perfect. All right, good. Okay, so, 94, wow. Okay, here we go. Yes, she was in charge of a lot of children. She shows me, yes? I'm not sure if it's a school or if she was teaching or she was taking care of. It seems to be a type of tradition. She's showing me, she's making something out of some type of, I'm not sure what that is actually. And it's, it looks like rope or vegetable plant type stuff. Does that tell you anything?
Yeah, she was an herbalist.
Herbalist, okay. Perfect. Herbs. Okay. So yes, thank you. Oh, okay. She's actually with a lot of other people. Okay. just a second. I'm just going to try to focus on her. Oh, that's interesting. Okay. So what I'm seeing now is she's there. She started speaking, Ojibwe by different consonants is how I know it's not English. She's very, very gentle and compassionate. And then there's other Aboriginal with huge feathers and stuff like that behind her. I'm not sure if they're warriors. One looks like, I think it's called Grand Chief. Is that possible?
That was who I was.
Okay. Okay, just a moment. All right. What else? Sorry, that threw me off. There's a lot more people than I thought. Okay. What did you want to ask her, Earl? For you? Okay. Build houses?
Yes.
Yes. She sees those. She says, great land. She shows me water and a lot of land with tall trees. And it seems as if those trees are being taken over by bulldozers and stuff like that. Does that tell you anything?
Yeah.
Okay, construction, this one. It's for the people, she said. Does that make sense? Okay. She said to be careful about the water. There's something either in the water or the way they're going to work that will affect the water of some type, maybe the course of it, or I see like red sand of some type. I'm not sure what that is. Does that tell you anything?
Yes.
Okay. What is that? Can I ask? I'm curious.
In our community, we had a sulfuric acid plant.
What? Sulfuric acid plant, okay.
A red chemical to service the uranium mines.
Whoa, okay.
So I was involved when I was younger in terms of getting it cleaned up.
Okay.
But maybe we didn't clean it all up.
Okay, all right, perfect. She's speaking about that place. Sulfuric acid mine. Yeah, the sign is quite, I thought it was blood at first, so I'm like, whoa. Is that what it looks like sometimes?
Red.
Okay. Okay, I'm not gonna play in that park. sorry. What, sorry? It just came out, I'm sorry. The grandmother, yes, thank you. They're telling me to stay focused. I do that a lot. Okay, so here we are. Yes, thank you. Patience, the land will grow, is what she's saying. Does that make sense? You know what she's thought? It's about a development of some project or something coming up. It seems it might be three. I don't think it's 3 months. It could be 3 years. It's very, very big and wide. It has to do with your people, she says, your people. It's for the children. So it probably is multi-generational and stuff. She's talking about, well, what do you know? What do we have here? Justin Trudeau. She's showing me Justin Trudeau. There's a treaty of some type coming up, I think. I'm not sure if it's, I don't think it's there yet. It seems to be further in a couple of months. It might be by the end of the year. There are land treaties or some type of stuff like that they're working on. They'll have his, yes, thank you. I'm not sure if it's it. I can't talk if you're talking at the same time. Yes. Okay. It has to do with project development and, you know, I see Justin Trudeau, it has to do with some type of deal or projects that are coming up, and it's as if the government is helping. The transition will be easier now. There seems to be a, yes, just a second here. So it's like before there was like a wall and everything you tried to do is like, like bureaucracy, she says, and now this is fading away. Does that make sense?
Yes, love.
Okay, and it's just fading. And then the, yes, thank you. The veil will begin to unveil, she says. Where am I? Okay, sorry. Yes, she says now there is hope.
Now there's hope.
Okay, and she's showing me, I'm not sure if they're politicians, but they're dressed up in jeans and like cowboy belts and that didn't sound too good, did it? They look like cowboy belts, and they have some stuff here, ornaments or Aboriginal ornaments, and some of them have the huge feathers and the white and red mascara, not mascara, sorry, the makeup stuff. How do you call that? Sorry, paint. Okay, sorry. I don't want to be disrespectful. It's just I didn't know the name. Yes, thank you. You'll be central in there in that, but you have to sell the story. You have to make it come true. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Ask questions because they're coming to meet her. Is that all the people I'm seeing in the house right here?
Yeah.
Okay, just a second. What's their name so that I know? I feel like a politician just shaking hands on the other side.
My father is Archie.
Is he the one with the big feather thing?
No.
Archie. Lloyd? Archie. Archie and Lloyd?
Yeah.
Okay, just give me a second. Archie, I think, is there. Did he have a big stomach?
Lloyd did.
Lloyd? Okay, that's him. Just a second. Does he have a bigger cheeks?
Yeah.
Okay, just it's easier to remember. I'm sorry. Okay, got him. What did you want to ask him? I haven't found the other person yet, but I'll start with him.
Does he have anything to say about what happened to him or his?
He says no.
No.
He says no. He says not here.
Not here. Okay.
Sorry. He doesn't look at it, he's joking. So, any other question? He's pretty serious and not here. He's like this. He has big cheeks, man. Okay.
I got his message.
He says you have to succeed.
I have to succeed.
Yeah, that's all he said. Does that tell you?
Yeah.
Okay. What? What did he say? No pressure, yeah.
Gotta succeed.
No pressure, that's a good one. Yes, thank you. Just one more minute, please. Go ahead. Arthur. Okay, no wonder I can get the other guy. Just a second. Arthur. Who's this guy? Is he tall?
Yeah.
Not slim, but sort of big hands and. Okay, got him. I know this sounds weird, me describing people like that, but it's easier for me. sorry. When he walked, did he look like a tree or walking?
Yeah.
Okay. Because it makes me think of the Lord of the Rings, the trees are walking. I'm not sure if it's patient, but sort of determined, but at the same time, just going slow. What did you want to ask him? I'm sorry. He says you have to succeed for the people. Hey, that's two of them. Poor guy, you're going to have freshman leave here. He said you already succeeded. He said you already succeeded.
I have already succeeded.
Yes.
Okay.
Does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
You know what he's talking about?
Yeah.
Okay. It's specific to what you just said, he said.
I've succeeded in forgiving him.
It's as if you went beyond something. You went through something, but you triumphed over something. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. That's what he's talking about. He's giving you, he seems to give you a hug.
Okay.
And he says he's sorry.
Okay.
Just a moment, now he's talking more than he was a while ago. Yes, yes. He says he didn't do it on purpose.
No.
Does that help?
Yeah.
Okay, yes, thank you. He says you need, I'm not sure if it's him, there's somebody else talking. He says, this one says, you need to know that.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. I think it's that older lady, that grandma.
Yeah.
Okay. Does that make sense?
That makes sense.
Okay. She says, open your heart. She's showing children everywhere.
Uh-huh.
Yes. Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. She has to go. Is there anything else that you wanted to ask them?
No.
Okay, perfect. Did that answer your questions, Earl?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Thanks again for coming all the way down here too, so I can meet you. Yes. Who's going to close the door? Yes. Okay. Wait. Yes. The guy, the tall guy, the tree guy?
Yeah.
Sorry. What's his name again? Archie, Arthur Archie, him, this guy. Yes, he shows me this and he says, thank you for opening your heart to me. That's what he wants to leave saying.
Okay.
Actually, what he's saying is, I asked him if they were leaving, but he wouldn't leave until he told you that. So I hope that helps. You heard what I said, yes?
Yes.
Okay, because I don't remember. Okay, just give me a second. Everybody on? Good. All right. Here we go. Okay. Just come back. Here we are. Okay. Good. Okay. How are we doing in time? We're good? Good. Perfect. What time is it? Oh, that's perfect. All right. I'm going to close my eyes just because I'm not ready to come back. Just give me a second here. Yes, thank you. Okay. Your grandmother says she loves you just before she went out the door.
Okay.
But the door in my head, that is.
Thank you.
Okay, good. All right, good. Okay, so, yes, you have a question?
We'd like to go next.
Sure.
Okay.
I'm sorry, just give me a second. I'm looking at you. I'm like, I'm like, what? Okay, just give me 1 second. All right, okay, so you'd like to go next. You want to tell your mom to go? Okay. Does your mom want to go?
Sure.
Yes?
I guess so.
You want to go? Okay, just give me a moment, mom. Not mom, you, her mom. Okay. All right. What's your name?
My mother, Amelia.
No, your name, please.
Because
I'm going to call you mom, but my mom's right there, so it's. I was like, what? She ain't no mom? Sorry?
Rosemary.
Rosemary, okay. And your age, please?
72.
72, okay. And the person you want to communicate
Amelia,
with?
Amelia, my mother.
Amelia is your mother, okay. Amelia. What's her age?
49.
When she passed? When she
49.
Passed, 49? Okay. Was it a shock? Yes? Was it? I hear a frontal collision. Does that make sense?
A what?
Frontal collision. Does that make any sense? No? Okay, don't tell me anything else. 49. Okay. Rosemary's her. 49. Shock. Impact. It's from the front. Where is she? Amelia. What's her last name, please?
Schwartz.
Schwartz?
Yeah.
Like Schwarzenegger, but just a Schwartz?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay. Like this one? Yes? Okay.
There's a Z.
A Z?
Yeah.
Z. Oops, sorry. Okay, perfect. Just give me one moment. Is it possible to get water?
Yeah.
Christy? Yes, thank you. Not the plant, though. I'm just kidding. Not the plant. Oh, actually, it's right there. I'm sorry. I can do it myself. Because I was looking at this one. I'm like, I don't want the water from the plant. Okay, thanks.
I'm like,
I'm drinking the water. Vitamins. All right, sorry about that. Okay, so okay, here we are. Okay, so it's from the front, it's an impact. I'm not getting it. I'm going to ask you, what I hear frontal still, frontal and collision. It doesn't, I still hear metal. What was she, what did she pass?
What, why?
Yes, how did she pass?
She blood clot in her lungs.
Blood clot in her lungs?
Yeah.
Just a moment. I'm not seeing her. Just give me 1 second here. Ah, swallowing. Good. Didn't pick up on that one. Where was she when this happened?
In the hospital.
There was metal around her, right?
It's a bad baby, I don't know.
The machine is on that side. I'm wondering, was she okay before? Or she sort of, was she eating something before? Or there was, did she have tubes?
No.
She was eating before, you said? How did the cloth?
Quite a while before.
How did the cloth get there? Do you know? No, they didn't say? Just a moment. Was she in the hospital for 3 weeks? No? How long was she there for?
3 days.
3 days? Okay, so I just have to calibrate my time here. No, not 3 weeks. So it's not 3 weeks, 3 days. Okay, so 49, 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, right here, there. Okay, just give me 1 second. Amelia Schwartz. Was she short, tiny?
Yes.
Okay, I got her. She's in bed, so I'm good there. How come I didn't pick up on that one? Ah, okay, here's a mistake. Got it. Okay, that's what she died of, but she didn't go there for that. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, got it. All right, so she's laying in bed, this one. Does she talk softly, but have a high-pitched voice sometimes? Yes, no? That doesn't say anything? No? Just a moment. I'm having a hard time picking up on her. I'm not sure why. What did she do beforehand when she was alive?
What did she do?
Yes.
She was just a housewife.
Housewife? Okay, just a second. And I see her, but I'm not sure it's her. Does she have three children? I'm seeing one, two, three. Does that tell you anything? No?
No.
Okay, so it's not her. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave some time to get back to be able to communicate with her. Because I'm not sure why I can't pick up on her. It's not very clear actually. Okay, I'll come back to her afterwards. Is that okay? Okay. Is there anybody else that would like to? Yes, sir? Your name?
Matthew.
Matthew? Okay. Do you wanna take note, Christy, so that I go back to her afterwards? In case I forget. Thank you. Two T's, one?
Two T's.
Okay. Okay, you want to speak to your father?
My mother.
Your mother? Mother. What was her name?
Ruth.
Ruth? What was her age when she passed?
44.
44. What's her last name?
Gordon.
Gordon? Your mom pretty strong? Strong woman?
Yeah,
sure. Yes? Okay. Like, I mean, her arms too?
Yes.
Not built, I mean, like that. Like that. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay, sorry.
Take a little bit after.
Just don't do it to me. All right. Yeah. 44. Okay. I think I got her already. Yes, strong. I keep seeing her arms. Did she point a lot? Expressive, that's, thank you. I like your words better. Direct is what I would say. Okay. Forceful?
Mm-hmm.
Not violent. Forceful means you know you're going straight. Okay, perfect. I think I got her. Just a moment here. And that looks like her. Okay. What would you like to ask her? Just a second. Oh, sorry, I didn't want to interrupt you. She's sad for a moment. Oh, why is she sad? Oh, she started crying. Okay, interesting. She said she's been trying to reach you for a while. Does that make sense to you? Yes? Okay. I'm gonna close my eyes, so if I ask a question, if you can speak a little bit louder.
Yeah.
Take your time. Yes. She's very happy you're here. She's very happy you're taking this time. This was last minute? Well, I guess so. What would you like to ask her? Sorry. She's crying now, but she's crying because she's very happy. So I'll just ask you to ask the questions while she processes this, I guess.
Is she happy where she is? Happier
Is your dad still alive? Oh, okay, because she's talking about your dad, but she's talking, that's why I thought you wanted to talk to your dad a moment ago. He's there also. Did you want to speak to both of them?
Sure.
Okay, this is your choice. Yes? Your dad's, okay, just give me a second. Your dad seems to be a bit bigger than you, and I still think your mom's the boss. Does that make sense? Let's put it that way. He's calm and, you know, I'd say groovy a little bit, but I think I'd be more afraid of the mom than the dad. They're both very nice. Your father's just there, he's listening. She seems to be doing most of the talking. Does that make sense? What did you want to ask them? They said they're proud of you. Are you working on something just recently, a month or two ago or something like that?
Yes.
Okay, can I ask what it is?
Yes, I'm actually opening up the new Barbecue World in Canada Central.
Barbecue World?
Barbecue World, yeah.
Is that, what is that?
Brand new franchise.
Oh, a restaurant.
Sort of like a restaurant, but they deal with like the niche market of like selling barbecues that are like 40.
Okay, so you're gonna sell barbecues.
Yes.
Or you're gonna make the food.
Actually, both. It's kind of like an IKEA meets Apple Store.
Oh, okay. What's it called again?
Barbecue.
And that's like 2 months or something
it's
in that sense?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. All right. So yes, thank you. Just a second. Sorry. Do you do ribs?
I do it all.
Your dad, I think, likes ribs. He's like that. And he's showing me ribs. So that's why I kept asking you. Okay, that's good. Nice. All right. I'm going to have to go there. Yes. Three? Are you opening a three franchise?
That's right, yes.
Okay. Yes, thank you. They'll watch over you. You're going to need to work on your, yes, thank you, on your time management, because you get very excited, but then you crash. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, thank you. Okay. Your mom's showing me pictures of you walking when you were a kid. The way she took care of you, she's showing me like this, and then she's showing me that she watched you as you grew and started to walk. I'm not sure why she's showing me that. It's cute, but I think it's more related to, yes, thank you, take your time, okay? Yes, thank you. It's like evolution. Do you understand what I mean?
Yes, I do.
Okay, so, yes, thank you. She says this is a very important lesson you need to, she's showing me you should write it down, so maybe on your phone or somewhere. We'll have it on video anyway, so, yes. Okay. Your dad seems to like food. Is that correct?
I wouldn't really know.
Oh, okay. He's just making jokes about the fact that he's showing me he's eating ribs all the time. A moment here, this one. Is there anything you would like to ask either one of them?
Why he hasn't been there since the time I was a child.
I'm sorry, say again?
Why he hasn't been there from the time I was a child.
Okay, just a second. He says... just a second. He turned dark for a moment. He's saying shame. It's not shame about you. It's shame about him of some type. Maybe he's ashamed. I don't know. He doesn't know what to say. He's sort of... I don't think he knows. It's like he wasn't able to, he's not capable of, or it seems to be related to capability or capacity. Do you understand what I mean?
Yes, I do.
Does that make sense?
Yes.
Do you know anything about this?
Yes, because he...
yes. Sorry.
He came by and looked for me like later in my life, so like after I moved out of the particular home.
Yeah.
When I was about like 13 or 14.
Okay, and?
He came back looking for me though for then.
Okay.
Like, I believe a year or two later he passed away.
Okay. What did he pass of?
Didn't take care of himself. Maybe too much ribs.
He's showing me something in this area here. Maybe he died from some sickness or something like that. Does that make sense?
That's what it sounds like from my
from your understanding. Just a moment here. It seemed he wasn't able to or capable of. Yes, thank you. It seems also he might have been prevented from some reason. I'm not sure what that means. He's showing me organizations or I'm not sure what that is. Were you taken away when you were a kid?
I'm not really sure.
Okay, they're showing me as if somebody's pulling you away from something or someone. It's not really clear. We can always talk later, thank you. They prefer, probably I talk to you one-on-one or something in that sensing. So keep asking your question regarding maybe something else. He's proud of you. He wants you to know that though. Okay. So this you need to know, he says. It wasn't about him, is what he's saying. So yes, thank you. So he says you can't blame yourself for any inequality or dysfunction or what's that word? Yes. Yes. Yes, that's very nice. You have the opportunity to create your own map. Do you understand what that means? Yes?
Yes.
Okay, so that's what he needs you to remember. You don't need to have his flaws, is what he's saying. okay? You're capable of. You have yes, thank you. You have access to more things. He's showing me the internet, books, the people you love. Yes, your heart, in terms of, yes, thank you, the character you have. So you need to remember those things. And remember your mom, he says. Fierce, feisty, like your mom, she's a fighter, sort of, how do you call it? Strong woman, does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay, it's like your mom, she's, this is where I'm going. So this is also, he says, yes, thank you. You can learn from that and you can use that. Do you understand?
Yes.
Okay, but the map, you can create your map. You can create your own map. This is very important for you to understand. Yes? Other question? Just a second.
What would my mother like to see from me?
I'm sorry.
What has my mother seen from me?
I didn't understand. It's your question is not loud enough. I'm sorry.
What would my mother like to see from me in the future?
Children.
I have children.
How many?
Two.
What's your question again, please?
What does she see for me in my future?
She still says children. Do you want more children?
Yes.
Oh, there you go. I don't know. She keeps repeating the same thing. I can't change it. I'm like, he just said he has kids. She says children. I guess you keep going. Sorry. Isn't it time for a break? It's 8 o'clock. I can't make her change her mind, so I'm not sure what you said, but that's the answer twice. All right. Any other question?
Is there anything that she'd like me to say to my brother?
Just a second. She loves him. I think something about missing him or something in that sensing. Is your brother okay? It's as if she's worried about him for some reason. This recent. Does that tell you anything?
Quite possibly.
Okay. Maybe she's just being a mother. I don't know. Did that answer your question? Sorry, I forgot your question already.
Okay. It does.
Just a moment. I'll ask her. Yes. Oh, all right. Thank you. They're coming to see them. Is there any other question you want to ask before they leave? They said, be a man. Do you understand what that means?
Yes, I
do. Okay, okay, that's good. It's like, be a man. Okay, well, all right. This is the last message, I think. And the love. Yes. Your dad said he regrets not being there for you, but you'll do fine. He's opening up the barbecue and eating. He's a funny guy. Yes. Be patient, all right? This is important, they said, or your dad is saying. Don't rush too fast. Watch your angles. I'm not sure what that means. You don't understand? Do you understand what he's saying? Okay, so you have to watch your angles. I'm not sure if you're dealing with two other people. I'm sensing two. I'm not sure what that is. But just be mindful of, yes. It's your dream, okay? Do you have partners
In
the business you're doing?
I do, two other partners.
Oh, those are the two they're talking? Okay, so just remember this part. It's your dream. That's what he said. Got it?
Yes.
Yes, thank you. Just a moment. It's your dream. Just remember that. Okay. Okay, thank you. I have to come back. Where's that door? Here it is. Okay. He's not leaving. Okay, just a second. I have to come back, man. Is there anything else you need to ask? That you didn't want to ask, or I don't know. Oh, yes, okay. I get it. Sorry. He just says he misses you. And so, yes, that's complete. Thank you. Yes, go ahead.
Has my mother's
Is she on the other side too, or what?
No, she's not.
What's your question? Sorry.
Has she reached out to her in any way, shape, or form?
I can't hear you. I'm sorry. They're talking at the same time.
Has she reached out?
Is your mom there? Has she reached out to your sister? Is that correct? No. Her sister?
Her sister.
What's her name? Here, that'll be faster.
Sorry, Aunt Erica. Erica, Veronica.
Erica, Veronica?
Veronica. Her full name is Veronica.
Her full name is Veronica.
But we all call her Erica. I'm so sorry. We all decided. Okay. Erica, I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry.
Your mom's sister is named what?
It's Erica.
Erica, got it. And what was the question? I forget.
Has she reached out to Erica?
Is that right? Did I get it right? Okay, good. Not yet. She seems to have, I don't know. I'm not sure. I don't think so. Does that answer your question?
Yes, it does.
Okay. It's as if there's something, a little something between them or something like that. Okay. Does that make sense?
Yeah,
all right, I'll leave it at that. Just, yes. Oh, good. Now they're leaving. Good. Okay, perfect. So I can come back. Thank you, anyway. Thank you. Yes. Okay. All right. Okay. I'm back. All right. You were asking questions, right? Okay, perfect. Thank you, Christy. Okay. Did that answer your questions? Yes? Okay, perfect. Just go ahead. I'm sorry. Yes, sorry.
Okay. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to pick up anything, but I know him.
How long ago?
He died earlier this year. I can't give you his age. He was early 60s.
Okay. What's his name?
Wilf.
Okay, just give me one moment.
His name is Pam, and she's my neighbor, and I ran into her tonight.
Okay, just one moment. That's too many names in for me right now. Just give me a second. Okay, so I'm communicating with who?
Wilf. And I'm here on behalf of Pam, his wife.
What's your name?
Pauline.
Pauline. Sorry, I'm still a bit dizzy, that's why. Pauline, and your age is?
54.
Okay. If ever you forget, check your driver's license. I'm just kidding. All right? Pauline and Wilf. Okay. Wealth and his age?
Early
60s. Oh, he passed recently this year?
Yes.
Okay, just give me a second.
His wife's name is Pam.
216, 217, and this year is. Before March?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. I think I got him. All right. Yes, just a moment, one at a time. And what was I asking you? Wilf and before March, and you were asking for Pamela.
For Pam.
For Pam? That's his wife.
Yes.
Okay. And what does she want to know?
She was very eager to come here because it was so last minute. She had other plans.
Okay. Okay, and what does she want to know?
I guess how he's doing.
Okay.
I know she misses him.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, just give me one. Would you be able to validate when I find this
yes.
person? Oh, you know this person?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, thank you. Where was he? I saw him a minute ago. He was here, so that's March. What did he pass away of? Chronic something?
Complications.
Okay, got it. I just see everywhere, like you're saying. Is that cancer or what is that?
No, it
seems
was,
to be chronic something.
Yeah, it was long-term C. difficile.
Oof.
But it was from an operation that had to be.
What about his lungs?
Yes.
Yes? Okay, I got him. Thanks. We'll just say lungs for now.
He eventually stopped breathing.
Okay, that's him. Got it. Yes, so complication. This is the fluid. We got it. Okay, so. We'll just say for the lungs. Okay, now that I have them, I'm just going to take a bit of water. Sorry. perfect, thank you. He says he's well, he doesn't suffer anymore. Like I said, the chronic thing, hearing, the breathing, there's crackling, so maybe his lungs were either very, his bronchs were very damaged or over time. Did he smoke?
No.
Okay, his lungs sealed, either failed or there's a sound to him.
He's on a breathing apparatus.
Okay, breathing apparatus, okay, that's it. It's just, I thought his smoking looked so bad. Yes, thank you. He says he's okay. Just a second. Ah, yes, thank you. He didn't want her to come. That's why she's not here. Do you want to tell her that?
Yeah.
Okay. Why? He's too sad. He wasn't able to take care of her for some reason.
Yeah.
Okay. Or he missed something. It's like a guilt of not being there, of being able to provide for her, something like that. Does that make sense? Yes, thank you. Did she have insurance? He's talking about insurance or something.
Big issue.
Okay. I'm sorry?
It was a big issue.
What was the issue?
There.
What's that noise? Oh, sorry. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's like, Mom, quiet. Okay, it's okay. It's okay.
It was to do with the mortgage.
The mortgage? Okay.
And it was,
so he feels guilty about that.
Yeah, she thought she was in a better
position. Okay. That's why he's saying he's sorry he wasn't able to take care of more of her. This happened like really fast. He wasn't expecting it, I think. It was something, just a moment here. Don't move. Yes, the sound of the lungs, I'd say, for a period of time, and then it accelerated really fast. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, his papers weren't in order or something in that sense. There's something missing on one of the contracts. He's showing you the page, top right. I think where's that contract here? I think it's the first, second paragraph of that contract. There was something missing and that made it screwed it all up. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, yes, thank you. This contract there. Let's see if he can fix it. No, okay. Lawyers. It's gonna be. Is it in lawyers and stuff like that right now?
Ask him if he knows.
He's showing me signing something.
Yeah, but there's something else going on. So
yeah.
Ask him if he knows about Monica.
Monica?
Yeah.
Monica. What's her last name? I don't need to know. Just a second. He knows. Mm-hmm. Be more precise. What do you mean?
His daughter.
What do you want me to ask him? I'm sorry.
She was in a bad car accident.
Okay.
And
this has to do with the insurance and all that, or not?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a civil case.
Okay, just give me a second. I'm sorry, I forgot. What was the question?
His daughter, Monica.
Yes.
Monica. A car accident about 2 months ago.
Okay. I just need for you to tell me the question. What do you want me to ask him?
That Monica's gonna be okay.
Wilf, just a second. Where was I? Here. Okay, there you are. Where was she injured?
Her wrist.
That's it? I'm seeing parts of her face or around this area that doesn't say.
She had a lot of bruising.
Okay, yeah. Just give me a second. He's saying this. Actually, maybe that's the risk he's showing me. Okay, I thought it was not sure, but it might be the risk. Okay. Okay, yeah, but he was going like this, so I thought he meant not sure, but it's actually showing me where she's hurt, which I picked up from what you said. Again, she'll be like this for a while, or for a period of time. There might be something there. If it's her wrist, there might be for a longer period of time. Another question? Did that answer your question, first of all?
Yeah, it could also mean like maybe the civil case might not go.
No, I was asking for her. The civil case I can ask about just a second.
Yeah.
It's not going to be good. It's going to be a hard fight. What's the civil case about? It's as if somebody's not going to let go, is what I hear. Does that make sense?
Well, they don't know if she was texting or if it was the weather, but she missed the curve and hit Monica head on, and Monica went into a wooded area down a ravine and broke her wrists and her hands. And
somebody hit Monica, or Monica hit somebody?
This girl hit Monica.
Okay, got it.
She wasn't paying attention.
Okay. Okay, so let me just ask him maybe how can this be resolved faster?
Yeah.
How's that? Okay. What does that mean? I don't know what that means. Okay. I still don't know what it is. I'm not sure if he's writing something. I don't know. He's showing me something. Or I don't understand what he's talking about.
Okay, I'll just mention it to Pam. Because Monica can't write yet. She has no use of her hands.
Oh, okay. So why is he showing me that? This? Can she write with her other hand? Is the civil case about her not being able to write or losing her hand? Is that it?
Yeah, she can't.
Okay.
She
can't what?
She can't look after herself because...
Okay, so this is what the civil case is about.
Yeah.
Oh, got it. All right. Because he kept doing that, and like, I don't get it. okay, so this. So I don't know what to ask him. What should I ask him? Yes?
Well, maybe just ask him if he has any messages.
Okay.
Advice for Pam. Okay. And then I can pass along.
He says, keep praying, you'll get through it.
Okay.
Okay. It seems to drag on for a while, though. Yes. Yes. They're going to find something in the car. He's showing me the trunk. I'm not sure why. There's something about the car. They're going to either find out or is around or in the car somewhere. That's going to help the case. There's something in the car. I'm seeing inside the car. Was one of them not a Jeep, but what kind of car was it? Do you know?
Just like a Toyota sedan.
And the other car?
I'm not sure.
I'm not sure. He shows me something inside the car, but I'm not sure what to make of it. He says to keep praying, she'll get through it.
Okay.
And for her hand, it's the same thing. He's showing me like an iPad of some type for something that's further down the road. Maybe it's related to physiotherapy of some type. Go ahead.
Okay. Is he in the house with Pam?
Just a second.
Can he
follows her sometime, he says.
Can he hear Pam talking to him?
He says he follows her somewhere. Sometimes, sorry.
She says he's always in her way.
He's quite dense, actually, for somebody on the other side. Does she have a basement that's sort of not done?
I think so.
That's...
Because he lost 100 pounds.
Yeah.
And he had hip surgery and knee surgery.
Okay. He's showing me the basement as if it's not done. So if she's sensing him there or the stairs or something in that sensing, they seem like narrow stairs. I'm not sure if that's done also. I'm smelling, what's that smell? It smells like the thing between the walls. I forgot what that is. Yeah, not mold. What's that orange? That's the one, thank you. You know, I have construction people here. the pink stuff, sort of. So I'm not sure if her basement is completely done or not. That it's what it might represent, but that's probably sometimes where he is.
Okay.
There seems to be, I asked him why he'd done the basement instead of somewhere else. He's ashamed of the fact that it...
I know what he's talking about. Pam is freaking out about all the tools he's bought that he's never used, and she's so fed up with going through and trying to figure out why he has 50 hammers and everything.
Okay.
Five of each, six of each,
okay.
10 of each. And it's like all these things he was going to do that he didn't do, and she's in the process of still cleaning out that.
Okay. That would cause shame.
Circular saws.
Nice. She should do a garage sale. Just a minute. I'll ask him. Okay, he's not saying anything. Okay, so I'll leave it at that.
Guilty as charged.
Yeah, it's probably. Yes. Okay, so this, yes.
So he sees her doing that right now, I guess.
It's possible. I know he's downstairs and he's like ashamed and he's cringing or he's like this. So, I'm not sure. I have an idea what he means, but yes. Yes. Tell her he's so sorry.
Okay. He should be, actually. Because Pam said it was a shock when she got through the papers for the mortgage and everything. She was shocked.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's a message to Wolf.
Yeah, he's not saying anything. Anything else? He just says he loves her and he's sorry. Not saying anything else. All right, so I'll let him go here. Thank you. Okay, sorry. All right, good. Sorry, it took some time. I kept asking him, is it normal I keep hearing Justin Bieber in my head? It's not too late to say I'm sorry. So maybe, you know, I joke about it, but again, maybe it's in that sensing. Maybe he's hoping it's not too late for him to say that. That's a good song, actually, now that I think about it. Yes, I need some. Okay, so what we're going to do, we'll take a 5-minute break, if you don't mind. They're just telling me I should take a break for 5 minutes, and then from that point on, I'll ask somebody else, or I believe. Okay, perfect. How are we doing on time? 8:30 already? Okay. All right. Okay, so just 5 minutes, you know, just relax. I'll just get water and something, and I'll be right back. All right, ready. Number 6730197. Get out. Cool.
Awesome.
All right, cool. All right, so I'll sign it at the end. I'll sign it. All right.
You're welcome.
You're welcome. That's a lucky man, isn't it? All right. What else did we have?
Flowers. Do you want to do the...
Oh, yes. Okay, so...
Like who?
Yes. So, Earl, since you were the first one to register, we have a prize for you. The prize is the online training and tuition program, which is online. So, I believe you're already on the online thing. Yeah, but that's okay. So you just need to click again. I'll give you the sheets, possibilitiesinmind.com. We checked your, I just need to sync it tonight, and then you'll have access to it probably by within the morning. So it's, yes?
I'll go grid.
Okay, so it's a value of $497. It's a 6-hour training program on developing those intuitive abilities. Okay, so just saying thank you again. All right, you're welcome. Okay, now back to, thank you. What's next? Sorry.
Do you want to do more readings, or do you want to do some flowers, or do the flowers at the end?
What about the flowers again?
They want to do readings.
Okay, so we'll do the readings. Yes? Yes. What was I again? I'm sorry? What are the flowers? I don't know about the flowers. I don't know what the story is for the flowers. Okay, so the thing said to learn how to communicate with your guide. So what I'm going to do is do a couple of more readings. I still have energy to go, so we'll do that. And then I'm going to show you how to communicate with your guides. We'll have a little bit less time, but it just takes 5-10 minutes anyway. So, all right. So who was, I forget, Rita?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
So Rita, I'm 38.
Yes.
39
summer, yes. 38, yes. Okay.
I would like to communicate with my godfather. His name is Jose.
Jose?
Yeah.
How do you?
J-O-N.
Yeah.
Just one. Okay, sorry.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Ramirez?
Yes. Okay.
R-A-M-I-R-E-Z.
Yeah. I've seen the name before.
He passed away in his early 30s.
30s?
So I think he was
32. Okay.
Yeah.
Around 30, 32?
Yeah, 32.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then, okay, so godfather.
Yeah.
Was he here in Canada or? Okay, because I sense he's far away. Okay, so Panama. Okay. Okay, perfect. Just a moment. So I saw him and he was there. I mixed that up with Mexico for some reason. Is Mexico close to Panama? No. Okay, I don't know. I just saw there. It's probably in the name also. Confused me. Okay, so Panama. Here we go. Let's see. Is he short? Okay, so he's smaller than him. Smaller than him?
About
yes? Okay.
Size-wise smaller, yeah, for sure.
Yeah, okay. I think. I'm sorry, what? Sorry.
I need a minute that way.
Yeah, sorry. Okay, I think I have him.
Okay.
Bricks? I'm not sure where I got that for. Does the word brick tell you anything? No? What did he do for a living? Still hear brick.
He passed away when I was fairly young. I think it was 10 or 11.
Okay.
From what I remember, he actually went from Panama, he went to the States, to Philadelphia, to Delaware.
Okay.
To study something. I don't remember. But when he came back, a few years later, he fell ill.
Just give me a moment. Do you know anything about him that if I asked you, you would be able to validate? Yes? Okay, just a second. I still see the word bricks. Does that tell you anything? No? I had him a minute ago, so he's there. That's far. So that's not Mexico. Chain? Did he have a specific chain around his neck or something that he might have given you or something? Does the word chain tell you anything? He's showing me a chain around his neck or a neck. Maybe it's a chain he gave you or something. Does that make any sense? He's showing you.
Me wearing a chain?
I'm not sure. He's pointing at you and he's telling me about some chain here.
I'm not sure.
Did he wear a chain? Around his neck, I'm not talking a wrapper chain, I'm talking like a crucifix type chain of religious type, yes, thank you. Religious type chain, yeah?
Yes.
What's this thing about bricks? He's showing me a house made of brick, I don't know. Yes. Did he fall ill?
Yes.
What was the illness? Okay, that seems about right. So, did he have a lover or something like that? Is what you think?
Yes.
And the lover, was he in, what type of work did he do?
He was a psychiatrist.
Okay, what's this brick? This brick's confusing me, man. It's annoying. Okay, just a second. Okay, so I see the boyfriend. What would you like to ask? I'm pretty sure it's him. I don't know about the brick. Maybe I'm just seeing the side of a house or something. It's a red
basically,
brick.
Basically, I just want to let him know that I'm open to any messages that he has for me
mm-hmm.
or anybody else that you see.
Write down what you want for love is what he said.
Pardon?
Write down what you want for love.
Okay.
Do you understand what that means?
Sure.
Okay. I don't know. Yes, no? Yes?
Yes.
Okay. He's speaking funny. Just a second. Why is he speaking like that? Go ahead. Another question you wanted to ask him? He talks really fast.
Okay.
Did he talk fast when you were there?
I think so, yes.
Okay. I'm trying to keep pace, but he's like making my heart go faster.
Will my situation have a positive outcome?
Well, you're sent. If you work at it, it seems like a couple of months or by the end of summer. Does that tell you anything? It seems to be a couple of weeks, but I would say more by end of, probably before the end of the summer. Does that make sense?
No, but that's okay.
It doesn't make sense to you?
No, it doesn't.
Okay, just a second, I'll ask him again. Ask me again the question.
Will my situation have a positive outcome?
Can you mention the situation, or does he know what the situation is about?
It's confidential on this.
That's okay. That's what it sounded like. It seems to be it's going to take a while. I would say before the end of the summer. That's what he says.
Okay.
Okay. I'm not sure what it is, but...
No, that's good. We'll leave it there.
Yeah. He seems to know.
Yeah.
He's smiling. Go ahead.
Will everything be okay?
You have to write down specifically what you want from it.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay. He says define it or write it down, and this is what you need to follow.
Okay.
This has to do with your heart also, I'm not sure. Next question.
I'm open to any messages that he has.
Okay, just give me a
second.
Yeah. Okay, just give me a second. He says open yourself to love, but he also says to be careful. That's odd. He seems to be a bit not trusting of anybody, him. Does that make sense?
Sorry, repeat.
He seems to be a bit distrustful of a lot of people, him.
Okay.
Does that tell you anything?
Yes.
Okay. Because he's giving advice, but I'm sensing he's giving advice from his own past. You know, okay. Do you know what I mean? So I'd be a bit, from what I'm looking at, it looks like take it and leave it type stuff.
Okay.
He was very hurt in the end, he said, sort of like a betrayal. And he felt alone, he said. Do you know anything about this?
Well, as a child.
It's like people left him. Because of a plague of some type, I don't
know. Pretty much, you know, Panama.
They went away from him.
Exactly.
It's like he was just a second. He's showing me they're leaving, and they're leaving him there, like an exile or something.
Yeah. Well, all his children, his nieces and nephews, we didn't see him for a good 3 weeks before he passed away.
Oh. It's related to touching.
Yeah, because he just started shutting down his system.
Okay.
Yeah.
He says he loves you from the little girl.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm not sure you look like 8 or 12 or 10 or something like that. You were there for a while to see him, is what he says. Is that true?
I was there.
Yes, just a second. Yes?
I went back to Panama in 2012.
Okay. He says he loves you and be careful for yourself or something like that. I'm not sure if that makes any sense to you, but he was very hurt in the end. It's like he felt alone. Let's see here if he's okay. Is there something you want to tell him? Because he's just looking at you.
I guess that I love him and that I know he's around. And that I won't.
Yes. He says, thank you for seeing me.
Okay.
Did the people shame him or something?
It wouldn't surprise me.
Because he looks like he's happy that you're talking to him or something, but he feels as if he doesn't deserve it or something. Do you understand what I mean?
Yes, I understand.
Okay. Does that make sense to you?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, thank you. Oh, careful. Sorry. You just jumped on me and like hugged me. I'm like, whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay, that's nice, but it just surprised me. Yes, thank you. Okay. I should have finished my Spanish courses, I think. He talks fast, man. Holy. Okay. I think he's happy that I'm talking to him also. Oh, no. Oh, that's on. Oh. That's good. When was this that he died? Is it around 1995?
Not earlier than that.
Before that?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm trying to do the math.
20 years ago is 1996.
No, it was probably 91.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, he just thanked me for the work that I've done with people with AIDS. He said, we've all heard about it. I'm thinking, okay.
Wow.
So just surprised, it took me by surprise. That's interesting. Quite interesting. Just a second, that threw me off. Where was I? Interesting. He says when you do work like that, it doesn't go unnoticed. Mm-hmm. I didn't know that. Where was I? Okay, yes, him. Let's stay focused here.
Is there anybody else around him?
There's his boyfriend. I think, I'm not sure. There's this guy keeps presenting me or showing me. Apart from that.
My grandfather passed away last year.
I don't think so. Not that I know, he's not there right now. Maybe if I went to look for him or something, but yes, just a moment. Do you have anything else you want to ask him? He has to leave.
Okay, no, just that I love him.
Okay.
That I can feel him around.
He says thank you, and he's sort of putting a, I'm not sure if it's his, this thing around your neck, necklace.
Okay.
But he's showing me that he's putting one around your neck.
Okay.
So I'm not sure if it's given to you before or if he's doing it as a symbol of thank you for now.
Okay.
All right?
Thank you.
You're welcome. Just give me a moment. What's his name? Okay, here we go. Just come back. Okay, good. All right, so I'll take one more person. Yes, this one, yes?
Sure, hi.
Hi, what's your name?
Tanya.
Tanya, okay, just write it here. With Y or?
I.
I, okay. And your age, please?
40.
40, all right. And who did you want to?
I want to connect with a friend.
Yeah,
Allison.
What's your last name?
Hertz. Evelyn. Spelled like Evelyn.
What kind of work did she do?
She did child and youth work.
Like some type of nursing type stuff? Okay, got it. I think I have her. All right. Did she look a little bit similar to your size, but a little bit smaller? Yes? I'm just asking, I don't care. You're funny. Maybe. Just give me a second. Allison. Yes, she sounds like some type of nurse or therapist or something in that sense. Does that make sense? Okay. What did she pass away of, actually?
Brain nanny or something.
Okay. Just give me a moment. I found her, but I just want to make sure it's the right person here. I think it's her, therapist. Yes, here we are. Youth, teens?
Yeah.
Okay, got it. I hear teens, stuff like that. One, 1, 2, 3, 4. Was it like in a community center or something in that sensing? Different classes or something in that sensing?
Where she lived?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, I got her. Yes, thank you. Yeah, that was fast. Okay, good. Oh, okay. She said she's glad you're here. Did you want to ask her something in particular? Were you there when she passed?
No.
She's showing me two people when she passed that were around her. You weren't one of those, no?
No.
Okay, just give me a moment. She's showing me the two people again. What does that mean? Were you one of her two best friends?
Close friends, but not one of her best
friends. Okay. I just see two, and she keeps showing me two people, or you're part of two. I'm not sure what the part of the two.
She was a single parent.
Okay.
So two-person
parent. Okay. It's possible. I'm not sure what the two, it means two and closeness. Go ahead. Your question, please.
I probably have a million questions, actually.
Take your time.
Just want validation that she's around.
Just a second. She's here right now. Is that what you're asking? Yes. Or around you sometimes? Do you write, what do you do for a living?
Same as her.
Okay, do you write long reports or long stuff? Okay, she's there when you're doing that. Okay. You write a lot.
Yes.
Okay, nice, long stuff. They look like, what's that? What are you doing? Recommendations is what you write down?
Yeah.
Reports and recommendations?
Yeah.
Okay, so she's there when you're doing that. It reminds her of what she used to do. Wait a minute, you worked together before? Oh, how many were you?
We all worked at CEO, so.
Oh, nice, good.
Huge team of people.
Okay.
I think specifically like validation that she's around, and has she made peace with what's happened to her?
Just a moment. Oh, what's her name again? Allison. Have you made peace? She says, I don't think it's complete. And she says it's not complete yet. There's still anger there. I'm not sure what it's about, but there's still some stuff there. Does that answer your question?
Yeah.
Okay. Did you want to ask her something else? She says, do you have children?
Mm-hmm.
She says you're a good mother. I'm not sure why she's talking about that, but she just wants you to know. She says you're a good mother. Does that help you? I'll wait, it's okay. I'll just listen to her talk. Here we go.
I was so skeptical when I came.
Did that help you, yes? I'll wait, you can ask more questions. I'll just ask if she has anything else. Okay. Is there one teen that's giving you, I'm not sure if we were working with teen or she was at the time, but is there one giving you a lot of problems or in particular? Yes?
Yes, sorry.
Yes, okay. Is he around 14 or a little bit more?
Older.
About 17, 14, 17, something like that? Okay, that's the one, okay. That's the one. Okay, so she's smiling, so. I think she finds it amusing, or I'm not sure if it's amusing, but she's just smiling. Yes, okay, so it's for you to know she's here, okay? Anything else you want to tell us? Never mind all the, I'm not sure if she's talking about bureaucracy, but people around you or on top of you or something in that sensing, sometimes you don't get what you want. She says to continue, do you understand? Okay, does that make sense to you? Okay. You have to fight it out, she says. Does that make more sense? Okay. It seems to be more specific when she says that. Yes. Did you lose somebody recently apart from her? Like somebody you worked with or a teen that it didn't go well or something like that? No? She's talking to me about something you lost, but it...
Not recently.
When was that? Yes. It's a case file, I think she says.
I don't know.
No? Okay. Don't name any names, by the way, so just to make sure. Yes? Go ahead, sorry.
I mean, you validated me. I think I just don't want you to stop talking. Because it's so validating to know.
Good.
Yeah.
Okay. Did that help?
Would she have a message for her daughter?
For her daughter? What's her daughter's name?
Her daughter's name is Cleo.
Actually, she knows her daughter. Sorry. I forget when I do this. I'm not sure. She says, don't let them take something away from you. Does that make sense to you?
Me or her daughter?
To her daughter. Cleo, you said, right?
Yeah.
Don't let them take something away from you. As she keeps repeating the same thing.
Yeah.
Do you know her daughter? I'm not sure. She keeps repeating the same thing. Just a moment. Sorry, what?
Incredibly close relationship.
What?
Incredibly close relationship, the two of them.
She had a close relationship?
Incredibly close.
With her daughter?
Yeah.
Let me see what that means. What do you mean by? She's not gone. That's what she means. Do you understand? So no matter what people say, she's not gone. The reality. Yes, thank you. What's her name again? Allison. She loves her. You can't take that away from her. Okay, so that's what she needs to remember. No matter what, she's gone or whatever the stories, she loves her. That you can't take that away from her. Yeah, can you tell her that? Okay, you'll remember? Okay, good, because I won't in a minute. Oh yeah, we're filming, so probably. Let's see here. She keeps saying you're a good mother, so. Okay, so I guess she wants you to know for sure. What, sorry? Okay. It's okay.
Can you tell her thank you?
You're welcome. Yes, yes. She has to go, but she said she loves you, and you were there for her. I think she's showing me two or three times in which it was very difficult for her. Do you understand? Yes. Thank you. Yes, I'm ready now. She says bye. But she's still around you when you're writing those reports. Okay? She says you don't have to be angry sometimes when you write them too. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Yes.
Can I ask one more question?
Yeah. Just a moment. Somebody was talking to me. Yes. Okay. So we'll have to wrap up soon, but go ahead for your question.
Has she found peace?
Yes. She says she's almost there. I see yes, but I see a little bit of something. I'm not sure what it's about, but she says she's almost there. I'd say she's there, you know, compared to what she was when she started her journey, I think. Yes. She says, thank you for taking the time to talk to me. Yes. She's leaving now. Okay, I want to come back now. Thanks for everything. Okay, here we go. All right, thank you. You're welcome. Did I answer your questions? Yes? Okay, perfect. All right. Yes, thank you. Okay, so, yes. Yes. So from the collective of all the guides on that side and the others that are there, they're telling me to remind you, yes, that you're not alone. That although, yes, thank you, that's very good actually. Although that your physical senses, your eyes, your ears are able to, yes, thanks. I'll explain here. So from your eyes and ears, and you have this sense of imagination, which I'll say, like, you know, when you watch the little bubbles and cartoons, this is the realm that I was in. You also have access to that realm. And so your eyes, your ears, they only have a certain frequency they can touch, all right? So like we say, you know, dogs can hear further away, they can sense further away. Those senses are what limit us to you being able to communicate with them. We're gonna take care of that in a couple of minutes. But just to remind you that you're not alone, that it's, yes, that's okay. So just like your remote when, you know, you don't wanna get off the couch, and you turn the channels, different remotes have, you know, 500 channels or this or that. You know, when I was a kid, there was like 3 channels and then 12, and then, you know, you turn it and go, shh. Now there's so much channel, you don't know what to do with them. Okay, so this is the same thing. They're called frequencies of vibration. So those guides are at a frequency in which your normal senses can't calibrate to, which means just like the remote control has so much, and before they didn't, it's a spectrum, okay, of light that they're in. So in a couple of minutes, I'll show you how to communicate with your guides, but yes, thank you. They just want you to know that you're not alone, and even though they can't see them, your unseen friends or colleagues or people on the other side or your guides, they're there. They're there with you. Through coincidences, through little things that you notice sometimes, they're just reminders to remind you that you're not alone. And they want you to know you're not alone just because they want you to feel that you're safe. All right? And from that position of safety, then you can start making different choices and decisions and be and feel more abundant. Does that make sense? Okay, all right. Okay, so thank you. I'm gonna now take you into the realm of communicating with your own guide. So the simple technique is very simple, okay? You just close your eyes for a moment. First of all, does everybody feel safe here? Yes? Okay, perfect, all right. So the first part is to allow yourself to feel safe. If you're driving, don't do this, okay? Unless you do it with your eyes open, all right? So the first question you ask is, how many guides or spirit guides do I have with me at the moment? Okay, and then you listen to the number, okay? So if you wanna close your eyes, please. How many guides do I have with me at the moment? And what are some numbers that come up?
Three.
Three? Six, okay.
Seven, three.
Three, good, all right. Most people will say three. Some people have 3, 4, 5. It doesn't mean you have a big posse that you're somebody that's better. It's like, yo, man, I got 5. Check it out, man. Okay, what, you got 3? Okay, it doesn't work like that. So next, you want to ask them, what's your function? Okay, so you want to know why they're there. Okay, so if you ask the question again, closing your eyes, now you know there's 3 or 6 or whichever number. Ask them, what's your function? What are you there to help me with? Okay, and what are some of the things you hear?
Enlightenment.
Enlightenment, okay.
Protect you, give you strength.
Strength, protection, good.
Guide.
Guide, okay. What comes up? Support. Audrey? Okay. How many, what's the number that came up? It didn't come up a number?
It's weird because I am quite
okay.
Intuitive.
Okay. Did you feel a presence around you? Either on the left or, wait a minute, on the right? Does allow yourself to let go mean to say anything to you? Allow yourself to let go. Does that say anything to you?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? That's the message. You wanted to hear a message? That's the message. Okay? So I see on your right, there's a guide there, a man. I think older 30s, he says to just let go. It doesn't mean that you know him or something like that. Yeah, it's a guide, so I'm not sure if he's on this earth before or not. It's just, he says you need to let go. And he's putting his hands on you like this to feel. You don't have to struggle so much anymore. Do you understand? Does that make sense to you? Okay. You have to calm. I'm not sure if you have illness or something you're dealing with. Yes? Okay. He says you don't have to fight it. You just have to sort of accept it and work with it in terms of allowing yourself to have hope and faith. Okay. And that you don't. Sorry. You don't have to do everything by yourself. You need to allow others to start. It's like you're putting a shield around you to either not tell other people, or you don't want people to know, or you don't want people to help or something in that sense. Does that make sense? Okay. Yes, thank you. Just yes. You're not a fort, is what it's saying.
Fine.
Okay. You shouldn't, okay. There's a lot of people around you to help you, but it's like you don't let them in. You understand? Does that make sense? So that's the message for you for tonight. Does that help?
Oh, okay.
Okay, good. Okay, she's like melting. It's okay. Take your time. It's okay. All right. So, yes, thank you. Yes. And so the idea behind guides, I came up with as a kid. Sorry, my mom's here, so this is going to be funny.
She's awesome.
Poor mom. It's okay. So anyways, I think I was 19. Are we still good on time? Everybody can stay? Yeah? So anyways, I'll just tell you a story. So I'm 19 years old. I think mom is when I moved out, wanted my own apartment, you know, get my own stuff. And I called my mom at the end of the week. I'm like, mom, mom, do you have any money to lend me? She says, why? I said, well, I didn't keep enough money to buy food. I forget, when you're on your own, you have to buy your own food, right? And she goes, did you buy those damn books again? I kept buying books all the time, remember? And so some of those books were on multiple personality disorder. And so unfortunately, it's a traumatic and very debilitating, I'm not sure if you want to call it illness or syndrome or whatever they call it, but I thought, wow, that's cool. You just change personality when, you know, things are really bad, something like that. And what I did is I started learning more and more. I could grab every book I could on it, because every book within it sometimes had the fact that they talked about inner self helpers. And I thought, wow, that's cool. You know, your own guides, your own people, and, you know, they help you behind the scenes and they help you create reality. I thought that was so cool. So one day, I think it's in 1998 or 2002, I was reading these books, and I found out that Dr. Ralph Allison, who's a psychiatrist who invented the term, coined the term, I found him on the internet. So I call him up and say, hey, listen, I love your stuff, man. It's like it's a celebrity. You know, when you're a kid, you talk weird. And so I said, listen, can I come and meet you? I really love what you wrote, and, you know, I use it in my therapies and stuff. And he said, so I flew down there for about 2 weeks. And at one point, you know, I'm at the motel, I'm sitting down on the bed, and he's right there, he's on the desk, and we're talking. I said, listen, you know, your stuff is the bomb. It's really helped me and to help change my clients. And, you know, I do everything you taught, and, you know, I read and I deducted this is what you meant. And I say, you know what, I help my clients by reading them, and then I have them contact their inner self helpers, and I ask the inner self helper, you know, what can you tell me to help them and stuff like that. And then it helps them faster, and he's like, that's not what I said. And I'm like, I just sank. I'm like, what? I felt so stupid. He says, no, that's not what I wrote. He says, that's what you understood I wrote, but that's not what I wrote. And I thought, oh my God, are you kidding me? And he says, no, that's perfect. He says, you invented something else. That's beautiful, you know, go with it. And if it works, keep doing it. And from that point, I always help people communicate with their guides. And any coaching I do from any level, the first thing anybody will tell you in my coaching is I help them communicate with your guides. The reason is they know they're like your historian. They were there when you were born. They're always there, and they're there helping you create and fashion the reality that you fashion. And sometimes we forget that we create our own reality, and you know, sometimes we'll blame our parents or our friends or our colleagues and stuff like that. But we forget at one point that we co-created it. And so that's why I wanted to do this with you and invite you to either learn it more from me or from others. We're going to be putting more stuff on the internet, especially small videos or articles I'll write. So I invite you to go and learn more from it. Okay? So if you want to just close your eyes again, please. Okay? So what I invite you to do is to thank your guides for, you know, making you aware that they exist and knowing that they're there. And also, I'm pretty sure they guided you to be able to come here tonight, either in finding the resources or the time or just the connections or just, you know, finding out about the event. And I want to thank them myself for bringing you. And when you're done, you can open your eyes. And I want to thank you myself personally for taking the time again this evening for this magical communication and conversating with your spirits. All right. Is there any more questions that you would like to know? Do anything else to give away or something? I'm still thinking, what can I give? The flowers? We're giving you flowers? Okay, perfect. Okay, good.
Also, did you want to tell them about how to connect with that online?
Yes. Oh, yes, perfect. Thank you. I forgot that part. All right. So if you see this, it says you won. All right, again, it's online if you want to register. I mentioned it in the beginning. If you just register, we'll send you the link for the online courses on how to communicate with your guides. All right? Any other question? Debbie, did you have a question? Yeah, go ahead.
I don't know, I wanted my mom to hear more from her mom, maybe.
Okay, yes.
What three might mean.
The three?
My mother's youngest sister was three when her mother died. So
three for what?
What?
What was the question? Sorry. I forget. I'm sorry.
Just validating the three that the major
said about Amelia, my mother.
Yes, Amelia was your mother. Okay. And what was the question? I'm sorry.
You said about three. There was three kids.
Okay. I don't remember. I'm sorry. I'll have
you
to go through.
To
okay.
Her.
You didn't connect with her.
She's the one in the hospital.
Yeah.
Is that correct? She's laying down. Just a moment. Amelia, what is her name?
Schwartz.
Schwartz. She had lung problems?
Yes.
Okay. She's laying down. She has lung problems. Okay. I think I have her. She doesn't talk much. Was she like that before?
No, she talked.
Okay. She's not. Oh, that's because she's laying down. Just give me a second here. Why is she not talking? Ah, perfect. I think I got her. Just a second here. She is mentioning three. What's the three about again?
There was three kids at home when she passed away.
Okay, just a moment.
And my younger sister was three.
She's talking about cooking. Does that tell you anything?
She cooked a lot.
Okay, I got her. All right. Why did that take so long? Oh, because I kept looking at her in bed. Okay, I was trying to find the illness. That's why I got stuck. Okay, perfect. So yeah, she's talking about cooking a lot. She's going like this a lot. So I'm not sure if she made spaghetti sauce or something in that sensing. Yes, the three children. Yes, okay. What did you want to ask her?
Is she okay?
Yes. She's not suffering anymore, she said. It took her a little bit more time to get on the other side, she said. It took her about 2 days. I'm not sure what that means, but she seems to be okay. Does she have grandchildren? She's talking about grandchildren.
She never knew, only knew one grandchild. She's got 19 now.
Okay. Okay.
There's one grandchild, will he ever see again?
I'm sorry, what's the question?
One She's... grandchild, will he ever see again?
Oh, that's, is he blind?
Yeah.
Okay, that's the one she was talking about. So, sorry, because you talked and she was talking at the same time. I didn't understand. There's one that has something with her with his face, something here. So that might be the blindness you're talking about. I'm not sure. She's not sure. She's showing me the future, but the child keeps having this here in his face. Okay, so I'm not sure if your question is, it will he
will he see again?
Will he see again?
Will he see something invented that
okay.
he didn't see?
I'm not sure. It could be, she's showing me 10, it could be 10 years, but so far she's still showing me that his eyes, they're like, I don't want to be disrespectful here, so I'm going to explain it the most. It's just like that, you know, like if it's
yes.
there, something like this here, and it's, I'd say it's like something I see in a movie. That's the best thing I can describe right now. She's not saying anything more. It seems to be farther along, but even there, I'm not sure. What was your other question?
Is she with my father?
She says hi. I'm not sure why she's doing that. Just a second. Okay, she's excited now. Okay, good. Took you a long time, man. he's not there right now that I see, no. Are you with her? Are you with her father? Is that her husband?
Yeah.
Are you with your husband sometimes? She says no, not now. He's like farther off that way. Let's see here. She wants to tell you something. She's talking about being afraid at night. Does that tell you anything?
No.
I think it's when she was about to pass. She used to be afraid at night or something in that sensing. I'm not sure. Go ahead. Other question? Sorry.
Does she come at night and cry?
Oh, that's probably it. I'm not sure. There's something related to at night. And it's not good.
It's not good?
Well, it seems to be, she's not smiling. She's like afraid or there's something there. I'm not sure what it is. Does that tell, you told me that doesn't tell you anything?
No.
Okay. Why did you ask me if she cries at night?
Who the woman is that cries at night? Does she know?
I'm not sure. It could be her. She's mentioning something close to what you're mentioning. It's something to do with at night and being scared or like this. I'm not sure. Sorry.
We're really not crazy, I promise.
I'm sorry, what? What?
I just said we're really not crazy.
That's okay. I'm not sure. There's something to be related at night and either scared or something is not functioning well. Yes, she's leaving. Did you want to ask her something else? It's like she can't stay for long. I'm not sure. Anything else you want to ask her before she leaves?
No.
Okay, just a moment.
Will all the family be okay? Or all her grandchildren?
There's three, she's mentioning something either with cough or something with their lungs. It could just be child stuff. She's mentioning three of the little ones. I'm not sure they're little anymore though. Yes.
Is it asthma?
It could be quite possible. It seems something that's just there and it's related to the lungs. It seems to be there. I don't know if it's gonna go away or not. There's a sound to it, so it's, I'm sorry?
Does she see the family sticking together?
Just a second.
The sisters and brothers?
No. Does she see the family sticking together?
Yeah, just give me a second. She's leaving. Why is she leaving? She's not answering. She's on her way, away. I'm not sure why. It could be because I'm tired. It's weaning away. She's very, she's hard to, it's hard to hold the resonance. I'm not sure if it's because of me or. Mother's family's thick together. She says, have faith. She says she loves you and she says, have faith. That's all she says. She's smiling. She's going away. Just a moment, I have to tell her goodbye. sure. She just left. Is there, you wanted to talk to somebody?
Deborah? I just had a question for my grandfather.
Okay, what's his name?
Alfred.
Just a second. Is he the husband of that? No? Okay, just a second. What's his last name? Sorry.
Zimmerman.
Oh, let me write it down. How come that pen's on the floor? Alfred, you said?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Just like that. Okay. What was his age when he passed?
67.
67. When did he pass? Because I didn't feel it was close to now. Can I hit that? No, just that one.
Oh,
yeah, it's okay. Just putting it all over my fingers. Okay, just give me a moment here. Was he quite tall?
Yes.
Alfred, and sort of husky, I hear?
Mm-hmm.
Yes? Okay,
yes.
I think so. Okay, I got him. Did you ever ask me about him before?
I don't think so.
Okay. He seems familiar for some reason. Maybe that's the man I saw a minute ago when I spoke with that woman, because he was far off. He seems to be at the same place. Okay, go ahead. What did you want to ask him? No.
Does he see what's going on in the family? And
yes.
How will it resolve?
The legal stuff? Or something related to children?
Just the discord in the
family. I see another woman who's very angry. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Woman, I see children or a child. I'm not sure if it's a little girl. Is it a girl or boy? Does that make sense?
She doesn't have children.
Is it one of your children that's involved? No? I see one. He's talking about one of your children, I think.
My son, maybe.
Your son? Okay, just a moment. How old is your son?
He's 20.
Okay, he looks younger. Just give me a second. Huh? Sorry?
Yeah, it could be possible when he was younger.
Yeah.
It's related to this issue.
Okay. Just give me a second, Alfred. Ask me the question again. Because it threw me off when you said his age, but it seems to be the little boy or the child.
Will the issue get resolved with this angry woman?
She's angry. You have to take it step by step, and you have to watch your back with her, because she seems to be. I'm not sure if vengeful or vindictive. Does that make sense?
Yes.
And she's pointing. She looks like a teacher that always looks for grammar errors everywhere on your piece of paper, even though you're trying to write a love letter. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Just give me a second here. Let's take another call.
Sorry.
It's okay. It's okay. I thought it was somebody on the other side, but I found that weird. So I'm like, oh, okay. Yes. You have to be very diligent with that woman.
Is she physically going to hurt someone?
I hope it's not me. Just a second.
Mm-hmm.
Physically, just a second. Okay, she's here. I'm asking him. You have to be very diligent. Sorry, I lost it. Just give me a second. Where was I? Alfred, yes, there we go. Okay. Yes. Take your time, take notes, and be very diligent. Because that woman, she can look for trouble very fast. Do you understand that? She can reach that phone really fast. I'm not sure if she's calling the police or somebody, but she can.
How can we resolve the issue with this angry woman? And should we my father make up to the angry woman? Should they have a conversation?
What's your father's name?
Ron.
Does he know your father, the Alfred guy?
Well, that's...
Your grandfather, sorry.
But they're father and son.
Oh, okay, just a second.
It's a brother-sister thing that's going on right now.
She's always been like that, he said.
Yeah.
So it's maybe not going to change even if he tries. You know, being nice, like you said, you just have to watch your back. Is what he's saying. You understand what he's saying?
Oh, yeah, I do understand what you're saying. Yeah.
Okay, just a second. I'll ask him if there's a solution for it. It might take many months from what he's showing me to get this resolved. Is this a legal case of some type?
It could be, yeah.
I see three things related to legal. To land, okay. Perimeters, boundaries?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, just a second. Oh, okay. He needs to offer more of a part. Does that make sense?
Maybe in her mind it makes sense.
If he does that, what will happen? No. She wants it all. I think at one point she'll get exhausted if it's dragged out, is what I'm seeing that he's showing me. Do you understand what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's just to put a wall and just let it until she gets exhausted. That's what I'm seeing. Do you understand what he's saying?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, thank you. He says it's like a virus. If you don't let it in, it just, at one point, it'll die. Okay.
Let her hit the brick wall every time.
It's similar to that. I thought my analogy was softer. But it's the same result. Okay.
Does Alfred know about the book?
Yes. Just a second. He's leaving also. I'm sorry. What book? What? Sorry.
Alfred know about
He says you have to be careful of legal implications in the book you're writing. What are you writing about?
Oh, just family. It's a family book.
You have to sort of refashion it a certain way. You should get an editor to make sure what you're writing is covered.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure what that means. Probably legally covered so that you don't have somebody get back at you. So if you don't, I see somebody burning the book to the ground. Okay?
Is he happy about the book?
You have to look in your heart, he says. It's not up to them to judge. Don't make it about him, is what he's saying. Is the book about him? We're going to go to a commercial now. All right. Is that, yeah, just remember what he said. Yes, thank you. He says bye. He says he loves you all. I think it's all of you here. He's doing this here.
We love him too.
Okay, yes, thank you. Yeah, that was funny, thanks. Yes. Okay, I'll just come back if you want to give me one moment, just a moment. All right. Again, thank you very much. Okay. I answered everybody. Okay, perfect. Oh, there's something else?
The
she wants to do the flowers.
She wants to
I'll take them. I'll take them. I don't know. We can do the flowers. Okay.
I just want to take them.
Yeah, that's okay. Yeah. All right. So, for flower number 1, 6730191. Yes. All right. Perfect. Good.
They're going to die in my hands.
You're a doctor. I'll keep them. All right. The one is 6730187. No?
Well, she's got a ton of water gum.
Is it yours?
I don't know.
Of course, yeah, yeah, yeah. Don't kill them. 6730187. Maybe. Okay, maybe it's somebody that left. Okay, take another one. Okay. Here, we'll keep that one. Okay. Just so it's. 6730190.
You got two?
You got two? How'd you get two? Okay, cool. Oh, that's for the person that came with you. Yeah, because I put, they're both under the same thing. There you go. All right.
How did you get two?
You got some more? Perfect. Here, let's do this. Okay. 673096.
Yay!
Yes, perfect. Okay. Okay, and this one is, we'll keep that one. 6730194. Nope, perfect. All right.
There you go.
Once again, thank you very much. It was a great evening. I hope you learned a lot. And again, we'll put it on the website and you'll have access to it. If anybody wants to buy our book, I think we have some here. And if you have any questions, I'll be here for a couple of minutes just to center myself. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you. All right.
You must be exhausted.
No.